I will bathe myself, then I'll wear you for the night. Colors fading, afraid at the sight.
Hello and welcome to the San Siro Stadium in Milan. John Champion here, and this, the voice of Jim Beglin.
Hi John, at this stage I think the players are just desperate to get out there, and this promises to be a terrific game.
Vinicius. He wants to get a cross in from here. Here's a header. Great build-up. Busy about the outcome.
And it all came from very good trickery in the wider position, but quite a static defence. Was pretty fortunate to survive that little episode. It should have been much worse.
He tried going it alone, but without success. To receive the ball, break could be on. Strikes it. Oh, a decent effort.
Well, this has been such a positive approach from them in the early part of this game. Everybody is programmed to get forward, and despite a couple of failed attempts, they are the better side.
Neither side able to find the net at the moment. Head. It's there. People will admire the header, but really it's the cross that deserves the praise.
Yeah, I just thought he wanted that more than anyone else on the pitch, and it was fully deserved. He gave it everything he had.
So we resume at 1-0.
Yeah, they may have got the lead, but that next goal now is absolutely crucial to the complexion of this one.
Looking to play on the break. Trouble looming, but he's able to cut it out. Barcelos. Trying to keep it in the face of strong opposition pressure. Well, if he wants to do something, he'll have to do it alone. Well played, that got them out of trouble. The whistle goes to signal the midway point of this game.
Well, you obviously have to give credit to the front men for the half-time lead, but I think the midfield can really pat themselves on the back too. They work tirelessly for me.
Tight old game this, 1-0 the scoreline. We kick off for the next 45 minutes. No, the defence alerts and kicked out the danger. Moving forwards. looking to receive the ball. Break could be on. He takes the opportunity to shoot. Played in accurately. And he'll drive it here. That is way off.
Well, the defender was stuck to him like glue, but he got his effort away. It wasn't quite enough, though.
He decides to shoot. He's unlucky not to score there.
Well, if he hopes to do better than that, he's got to work on his technique and his timing. The contact wasn't right there, so there wasn't much chance of success.
Looking to play on the break. Apoel still not utilising their bench. And a much needed intervention that was too. Possibility for a shot. The keeper just about got to it. And he wasn't far off.
I think what we're looking at here is just a very special talent. Someone who can decide the outcome of a match on his own.
So from what I can see on the touchline, we're on the brink of a substitution. Guilherme gives away a free kick. He'll be disappointed with that. Barcelos. Oh, he's lost out there. Hits it long. Looking to receive the ball. Break could be on. The keeper has claimed it. The clock counting down. Victory is tantalizingly close. They're just waiting for the whistle to come. Averted for the time being. The referee brings the game to a close. This could be put down as a victory for a set of defenders who all kept their focus for the full 90 minutes.
Well, once they got that goal, I just thought they were very dogged in seeing the game through. And that clean sheet, you know, key to the win.
And that's the end of tonight's broadcast from me, John Champion, and my co-commentator Jim Beglin. A very good evening to you.